Hello and welcome to Vani Smart Online Class. I'm Brija, the Faculty of English, and today I have come with a short video that is bare infinitive. Well, before starting bare infinitive, let's understand what is infinitive. Infinitive, which is a very important chapter in your English grammar, and in every exam you may get 1 to 2 mark questions from this chapter. So first understand what is infinitive. Well, infinitive is the basic form of the verb. Like, you know, there are 5 forms of the verb, like go, went, gone, going, goes. Go is the first form of the verb. We call it verb 1. We call go as the verb 1. And this verb 1 is the basic form of a main verb. And this is called infinitive. And the usage of the infinitive, we can divide it into 2 types. First, we can say full infinitive. Second, we can say bare infinitive. Full infinitive means when 2 is used with the basic form of the verb is called full infinitive. That is 2 plus verb, where I have mentioned it. And bare infinitive, which is also known as zero infinitive, is the only basic form of the verb, that is verb 1. Here I can say 2 go. Here I can say only go. So, 2 go is full infinitive, go is zero infinitive or bare infinitive. Clear? Here I have also given example like the do or to do, be or to be, do or be. We can say infinitive, sorry, which infinitive? Zero infinitive or bare infinitive, to do or to be, we can say full infinitive. Clear? Now come to the point where we should use bare infinitive, and from these points you may get question in your exam. Well, bare infinitive is used after the modal or the dummy auxiliary verb like do. So here I have given example, I do know him. Here I have given example, I do know him. Know is the main verb or is the basic form of the verb. We can call it zero infinitive or bare infinitive. Do is the auxiliary. Which auxiliary? Primary auxiliary. Him is the object. In the second sentence, I do love my country. Here, do is the auxiliary. Love is the, that is zero infinitive or bare infinitive. And my country is object. Clear? I can do it. I can do it. Here, do is used as the basic form of the verb, that is zero infinitive, and can is used as modal, or we can call secondary auxiliary. In your verb class, I taught you 2 types of auxiliary, primary auxiliary and secondary auxiliary. Do, have and we verb are called the primary auxiliary, and all the modals are known as secondary auxiliary. You can know this concept if you go through our verb classes. Okay. Now come to this point. Here I have mentioned a sentence, he dare not go in the dark. Here dare not is used as modal. So go is known as zero infinitive. Why? After modal we have to use go. But sometimes you may get questions like he dare not to go in the dark. He dare not go in the dark. Remember, he dare not go in the dark. Here, it is an incorrect sentence. Why? Because after dare not, we should use zero infinitive, because dare not is used as modal. But when I write, he does not dare to go in the dark, it is a correct one. Why? Here dare is used not an auxiliary verb or not as modal verb, rather it is used as an ordinary verb. So after, when dare and need, when dare and need is used as an ordinary verb or as a main verb, that time we have to use 2 plus verb 1 or full infinitive after there or need. But when there or need is used as modal, that time we have to use only bare infinitive, not full infinitive. Clear? So, he dares to go outside in the dark. Here, dares is used as a main verb. But in above sentence, dare not is used as modal. Clear? So, that is the reason go is used after dare not or modal. And but here, to go is used after main verb. Clear? Well, bare infinitive is also used after verbs of perception like see, hear, notice, watch and observe. So, whenever you find see, hear, watch, notice and observe, that time we have to use bare infinitive. We should not use or we do not use 2 plus verb 1 or full infinitive, we use bare infinitive. Let's understand this example. I saw him go there. Here I did not write, I saw him to go there. If you find the sentence like I saw him to go there, then it would be wrong. I watched it to happen. I watched it to happen. Then it would be wrong. So remember, I saw him go there is the correct one. I watched it happen is the correct one. Clear? Bare infinitive is also used after certain verbs like make, beat, let and have. Let's understand this example. I made the students write an essay. Here, I did not mention to write. Why? Because made is used. Made is the past form of the verb make. The teacher let him go out. Here, I did not write to go. What did I write here? Only go. Why? Because let is used. Clear? Now, follow the next example. The student was made to write an essay. Here, the sentence is correct. Why? Because here, make is used as in passive voice. So, what did you learn? When make is used in passive voice, that time we use full infinitive or 2 plus verb 1. But remember, this concept, this structure, this rule is not applicable with the let. Let is the only verb where we use bare infinitive both in active and passive voice. Well, bare infinitive is also used with the structures like have plus object. You all know have always takes the third form of the verb or the verb past participle form. But remember, when have is followed by any object, then we have to use the first form of the verb. Let's understand this example. I will have him believe it. Here, have is the verb and he is an object. Then we use believe. That is the bare infinitive. If you write to believe or believed, then it will be wrong. So, always use after have plus object, that is first form of the verb or zero infinitive or bare infinitive. Next example, she will have me recite this poem. So, have plus object, then we use verb 1. Clear? Remember, bare infinitive is also used after the words like had better, had rather, and would better. You had better to come now, this is wrong. So, it should be you had better come now. Clear? Well, bare infinitive is also used after but, than, and, except. Clear? Here an example. He did nothing but cry. If you get the sentence like he did nothing but to cry, then it should be wrong. So, after but, we have to use cry. Now, read the second sentence. She did no more than to sleep the whole day. This is wrong. Why? After then, I have used full infinitive. But read the second, third sentence. She did no more than sleep the whole day is correct one. Why? Because after then, I have used verb first form, that is sleep. Clear? Read the next sentence. She had nothing to eat except to drink water is wrong. She had nothing to eat except drink water. Except drink water. We have to use verb first form. Rather, 2 plus infinitive should be avoided. Clear? Well, bare infinitive is also used with certain phrases like why not and why. Why not rest now? Don't say, why not to rest now? It would be wrong. Why not to stay here is wrong. Always say, why not stay here? Always write, why stay here? Don't write, why not, but why to stay here? Clear? So after why not and why, we use bare infinitive. We do not use full infinitive. Clear? Well, hope this video will help you a lot to understand the concept of bare infinitive. If you want that we should make such type of important video, then please do like and share our video and subscribe our Vanik online channel. Thank you.